Hello, everyone, and welcome to Fabric Tech Talk Fridays. I'm your host, Patrick LeBlanc, and today I have the community maven with me, Rie Merritt. Rie, welcome to the show.
Thank you very much. I'm really glad to be here.
Yeah. Rie, before we get into all this wonderful community stuff, why don't you tell the people who you are and what you do?
I'm Rie Merritt, Principal PM Manager with Microsoft. I run the Influencers Community and Events team under Community, under Arun Oolong with Azure Data. And that means that I am in charge of the product group liaison, their connection with MVPs, super users, community, events, all that kind of stuff. FabCon now falls under my purview, but I have amazing team that help do all of this.
We're talking about purview or?
No, okay. We're not talking about purview.
Okay, I thought that's what we were going to talk about.
No.
Today. Okay.
All right. No.
So you mentioned MVPs, and I don't know if you knew this, but back in the day, I was an MVP before.
Me too.
Yeah. Right? Before I joined Microsoft. I don't know how I would make it these days. But anyway, so why don't you tell us, since you mentioned MVPs, what is an MVP?
So an MVP is a technical professional, very knowledgeable in their field, that can do deep dives on tech, but does that, uses that technical knowledge to help the community.
And I think that's the thing though,
yes,
right?
Absolutely.
You can't just be a tech person, not sharing all the stuff you learn. You gotta share some stuff.
You can be the smartest technical person in the world. And if you don't share it, you will never fall onto my radar.
Okay, so speaking of your radar, if I'm someone out in the community doing the work and I aspire to be an MVP, what are the things you look for?
So the word that you used is actually really, really important. And I tell people that a lot. An MVP is something you should aspire to be. It's not something you should pursue. So you have to find something that you're passionate about, right? Something that you love doing in the tech sphere, right? That falls under Microsoft's technical stack, right? And then do that. And then the award should follow.
So I do Power BI. That's my thing, right? When people think of Power BI, when they think of Patrick, they think of Power BI.
Accurate.
Right. And so so I would go out and I would focus in on Power BI and start doing it and maybe go deliver some user group sessions.
Absolutely.
Or write some blog posts, or in my case, do some videos.
Yeah.
Okay.
So if that's your jam, absolutely.
Yeah. But if you could give the blueprint, right? If you can write a blueprint and share with people out there that's aspiring, right, to become an MVP, what would the blueprint look like?
Well, so there are about 3,500 to 4,000 MVPs globally, right? So in the data platform, which is the part of the MVP program that I run, we have somewhere between 350 and 400 on any given year. So globally, so the odds are never in someone's favor anyway, right? So, but what I would want that person to do is blog, speak, record videos. You can mentor, organize user groups under the Azure Data tech stack, right?
Yeah.
So Fabric, Power BI, real-time intelligence, Azure SQL databases, SQL Server databases, Cosmos DB, everything that falls under Azure Data, that technology, sharing that technology out there with the world. Is what gets you noticed, it what gets you credit to become an MVP. And it's important that that it be shared publicly and that it be something that you can do. I have MVPs who never speak. They don't present on stage.
Usually.
Right? And I know a lot of people think that you have to be a speaker, you have to speak at big conferences, whatever. If that's not your jam, don't do it. Right? Blog. Some of the advice that I give to people with regards to getting started blogging is to not just go out and fire up their own blog.
Sure.
Because then you have to worry about how the search algorithms work, right? How are people going to find you?
Yeah.
So
you got to build a following. You're starting from zero.
So you start on LinkedIn.
Yeah.
Oh, LinkedIn has blogging capability. Blogged on LinkedIn, you're already connected to people on LinkedIn who are interested in the stuff that you're interested in.
Sure.
They can help share it on your behalf, right? They're going to read it. They're going to like it. They're going to, you know, boost that because then the people that they're connected to are also interested in the things that you're interested in.
Okay, Rie. So Right, I'm aspiring, but why do I really, what's the benefit of me becoming an MVP?
So what's in it for me?
What's in it for me?
Nice. Yeah. So MVPs get a lot of stuff, right? So, and sometimes stuff is access.
Okay.
So MVPs get benefits where they get, you know, Azure benefits every year to use products, our products. You can use that for, you know, if you're blogging, screenshots, right?
Yeah.
To show how you're doing it, or demos, recording demos. Yeah. You can use those environments for that. But the access that you get is to the product group, right? Ooh. To the people who build the products. We have
that's key.
Yeah, regular things that are called PGIs. They're product group interactions. They're secure NDA content sessions. Sometimes they're focus groups. Sometimes they're the product group delivering information to you about what's coming, roadmap, those kind of things. Teaching you about new products, new features, you know, a lot of things like that.
Yeah.
But you get to then provide feedback and kind of influence the product just a little bit. But the product group gets a lot out of that too.
Yeah, yeah.
Right? So it is a two-way street.
You're you're helping influence and shaping the direction of the product somewhat, right?
Absolutely,
yeah,
absolutely.
Yeah,
yeah. Yeah, give awesome. Access to private previews.
Yeah, that's awesome.
Yeah.
So if I follow these things, mm-hmm. right? If I've talked to you, I know what you're looking for. I know, you know, how do I become one? What's my first step? What's my I have the aspiration to do it. What is the very first thing?
So the only way you can become an MVP is to be nominated. There's a whole process that you go through. You can only be nominated by an existing MVP or a Microsoft FTE.
Oh, okay.
It used to be several years ago, you could actually nominate yourself.
Yeah, yeah.
And so part of that process is once you actually are nominated, you have to go in and put in all of your activity for the last 12 months. So we only look back 12 months. If you did something fantastic 2 years ago, great. It's not going to count when I consider the award. So it's only for one rolling year. So start keeping a track of everything that you do.
Yeah.
Right? Keep an Excel spreadsheet of, I presented at this user group. Here's the link for it. Mm-hmm. This is how many people attended.
Yep.
Because once you get nominated, that helps me measure how deeply technical you are.
Yeah.
How many people attended helps me see your impact.
Yep.
What region you're in helps me measure your impact in that region. All that kind of stuff. So you're going to get nominated by a Microsoft MVP mm-hmm. or an FTE. And to do that, I don't recommend that you just ping anybody you know and go, hey, can you nominate me for MVP? Because they're going to message me and go, hey, I don't know this person.
Sure.
And they just asked me to nominate them for MVP.
Yeah.
I don't know what they've done.
Yeah.
But it is appropriate to reach out to an MVP that you might have met or known or an FTE and say, I'm really interested in becoming an MVP. I'd like to talk to you about what it is that I'm doing. Do you have any advice for me on what I could change? And have them help you through that process.
Got it.
Maybe they'll look at the spreadsheet that you already have and say, you know, I think you have enough.
Yeah, yeah.
Then it's okay to say, well, if you think I have enough, would you be willing to nominate me?
Oh, wow. All right. So now we have the blueprint. Now,
yes.
That's a lot to take in. Can you tell us where, you know, these aspiring people can go to get more information?
Absolutely. So you can always go to mvp.microsoft.com. That is the main Microsoft page. There's FAQs. They answer a lot of questions.
Yep.
But if you ever attend user groups, events, whatever, there are MVPs there that are speaking regularly. Approach one of them.
They're willing to talk. All right.
Absolutely.
All right. Thank you so much, Rie, for taking time out of this busy. I know this week is busy for you. This time of year is super busy for you. So thank you so much for taking the time. Thank you all so much for taking the time to hang out with Rie and I. This is a great conversation. I really appreciate it. If you have any questions, you know what to do. Post it in the comments below. If this is your first time visiting the Fabric YouTube channel, be sure to hit that subscribe button. And if you like our video, give us a big thumbs up. And as always, I'm Rie and myself. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next Friday.
Thank you everyone for watching. If you found this video valuable, don't forget to hit that like button.
If this is your first time visiting the Microsoft Fabric YouTube channel, be sure to smash that subscribe button.
Drop a comment below on what you would like to see on the future episodes of Fabric Tech Talk Fridays.
That's it for today. See you all next Friday for another deep dive into Microsoft Fabric.